Saint Ignatius of Antioch. This Ignatius was one of the first bishops of Antioch, leading the nascent Christian community there in a time of persecution. But we know very little else about him except that he died in Rome, a martyr for the Christian faith. We don't know when or where he was born. We don't even know exactly when he died. If you look him up online, you'll find a variety of suggestions for the date of his martyrdom. According to tradition, he was executed during a persecution of Christians under the Roman Emperor Trajan, whose reign lasted from 98 AD to 117. So the safest estimate would put Ignatius of Antioch's death sometime between 98 and 117 AD. But we don't even know that with absolute certainty. Most of what we really do know about him comes from seven letters he wrote as a prisoner on his way from Antioch to Rome. And these tell us more about the church at that time, which is really why they are important, than they do about the man writing them. Although it would have been unusual for a Christian prisoner to have been condemned in Syria and transported to Rome for his execution, and also unusual for him to have made a long, circuitous trek overland as part of his journey, that seems to be what happened in the case of Ignatius. And as he traveled through Asia Minor, he encountered groups of Christians who were eager to see him and encourage him, and he them. At Smyrna, he made a longer stopover where he spent some time with Polycarp, the local bishop, who also became a martyr at a later date. From here he wrote his letters to the Christian communities at Ephesus, Magnesia, and Troas. He also wrote one to the Christians in Rome, who apparently felt they might be successful in getting him freed. He begged them to stop their efforts. Martyrdom was something he greatly desired. After his departure from Smyrna, he wrote a further three letters to the communities at Philadelphia and Smyrna, and one personal one to his friend Polycarp. What is so important about Ignatius' letters is that they contained some extremely early and rare evidence of the nature of the church in the generation after the apostles in terms of both structure and teachings. If we keep in mind that the New Testament as such did not exist until the 4th century, then we can see that these letters are a valuable piece of our history, revealing a continuity between the apostles and their most immediate successors, as well as the antiquity of some of our traditions, which don't necessarily appear in the Gospels or the Epistles. To give just a few examples, these letters are our earliest evidence for the use of the term Catholic, meaning universal, in connection with the Church, and the word Eucharist in reference to the Blessed Sacrament. They also show the hierarchical nature in which the authority of the bishops was understood and the primacy of the Bishop of Rome. There has been a long debate over which, if any, of Ignatius' letters are genuine. There are six possible others, and which of the versions that have come down to us most likely gives us the original texts. One of the fascinating or frustrating, depending on your point of view, aspects of belonging to a church with such a long history. But today, most scholars agree that there are seven authentic letters written by Ignatius and that they are the versions which I have linked to above. According to Ignatius himself, he was condemned to be devoured by wild beasts, and that's how his martyrdom was remembered in tradition and recorded by later generations. What the beasts left of him was gathered up and brought back to Antioch, but in 637, his relics returned to Rome, where they now reside in the Basilica of San Clement, just around the corner from the Colosseum, the site according to tradition where he met his death. His feast day is the 17th of October. Allow me to become food for the wild beasts, through whose instrumentality it will be granted me to attain to God. I am the wheat of God, and let me be ground by the teeth of the wild beasts, that I may be found the pure bread of Christ. The Epistle of Ignatius to the Romans.